wash, I think she knows what time it is.
Ask everybody to stand and join us for the pledge of allegiance.
Isn't really sure.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
God bless America. Roll call, Walter, please.
Mr. Hodgson.
Here.
Mr. Armstrong.
Here.
Mr. Kenwright.
Here.
Mr. Jones. Mr. Snoddle.
Here.
Mr. Kenwright. We have a forum.
Okay. You should receive, excuse me, in your packet, the meeting minutes for June 22nd. There were a couple glitches in it that I noted to Walter. Duplication of, I think of a title and of a roll call, so this has been taken care of.
Nearly every meeting, Schnabel's misspelled somewhere. I'm wondering now if that, if you're just seeing if I'm reading the minutes or if you care if I bring that up.
How would you like?
I really don't care. But under the deer hunting policy, T. Schnabel.
So, it's not purpose, I want to be sure that I read it.
You can.
Yeah, we want you to feel.
Good job.
Yeah, I should have, but, you know.
Okay.
Like that.
Yeah, it's right there.
Yeah, yeah.
No, we should just all hold our pen.
That's how I know, that's how I know the phone solicitor is the phone solicitor. That's just gonna help.
So, anyone would like to make a motion?
Motion to approve as amended.
Second.
Any further discussion? A roll call, please.
Mr. Hodgson.
Yes.
Mr. Armstrong.
Yes.
Mr. Kenwright.
Yes.
Mr. Schnabel.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Moving right along, our attorney report.
I have nothing specific to report that should be interpreted as meaning I haven't been hard at work because of the Porter County Board of Parks expectation.
You're still not getting paid, Rex. Okay, staff reports, you should have received a multi-page staff report. I'll let Walter hit the highlights and make any appropriate.
Yep, very, very, very quick highlights and try not to redo everything that's really here. The summer has been very hot and very long, and staff has done a fantastic job. Summer camp officially ends tomorrow, which is one very exciting and ready on the great night of the last couple weeks. It has been filled with lots of fun kids. Everybody's really tired after the last 9 weeks of work, but it's going to be very, very quiet at Sunshine Hill Farm on Monday morning. That's going to be great too. So that's moving forward. Just also want to again make a plug for August 21st is the day of caring on Churchill Hill Farm at 9 a.m. It's going to be a really good time. Matt Brown, Nicole Sheridan Murray, Danny Yay, Ray Joseph have all been working their tails off, getting a variety of things ready, whether it's marketing, whether it's plans, whether it's materials, whether it's actually starting to tear out the old pathway that's over there. This has just been a really keen effort, and we're really excited. The 21st is really going to be the capstone to this. We're going to be a couple hours. placed in the report, I just thought it was really, just going to check some mic. Thought it was really cool on Sunday. We had, Sunday was really great on Sunset for a couple of reasons. One, the Porter Chesterton Rotary, the fundraiser out at the amphitheater. So we had another music festival that occurred out there. It was a fundraiser for the community. What I'll tell you is it was a really great success. It was really cool to see all those people out there on the hill having a great time. All local vendors being used for food and drink. What was really cool for me, I shared with Mike before the meeting, Nippo was doing the tractor rides for the event, and there were gods and gods of smiling kids that I don't know if they'd ever gotten a ride like that before. So we're going to try to see if we can find some way for Mike and Nippo to be more formally involved next year. So we can get them to kind of just market the fact that if you want, you can ask the tractor club to provide shuttle service for your events, essentially, that's all you're doing. Bringing them from the parking lot to the amphitheater, but due to fun, you're giving these kids free ice cream from the face that I saw from my kitchen window. It was really cool. Visually, I want to mention that when that all was coming together, we got another phone call from a couple of local artists who wanted to see about doing a performance at the amphitheater. And we kind of scratched our heads and put this together and see if we could make this work. It appears it's not done yet. We're going to have a collaboration between a couple of local bands, the Memorial Opera House, the Expo Center, and the Parks Department to facilitate the event. So the Expo Center is looking at providing some of their resources. They have some technical staff that's going to be able to help us out there. They have a ticketing website, quite frankly. The Expo Center has a food vending experience, and they're looking at, we'll meet with them tomorrow, so I can't guarantee it all, but they're looking to help us out with delivering some food and beverage. The agreement is per the park board policy that the funds that they generate for this over the costs are proposed to be split between the Opera House Foundation and the Fort County Parks Foundation. So we share the post, probably a pretty small contribution where people are real tiny right now, but at the end of the day, if it means these guys are doing a performance, they says we want to see more kids learning about performing arts, we're going to help that happen. So really excited to see county entities come together. That's one example. The other thing that I apologize, I forgot to mention, two agencies that are doing the other significant amount of work on the day caring stuff, specifically the playground, is the surveyor's office and the highway department. And quite frankly, we wouldn't be getting this done if it wasn't the surveyor's office and highway department helping us out with this. So we appreciate that.
What time is that on the 28th?
The 28th, I think we're talking about 5 o'clock start.
And that is a Friday, right?
Yeah, it's a Friday night. It's a family thing. So it's all ages, family show, I think, and Fresh House, I think they're a bluegrass style band. So should be fun. I'm excited to see the live music for that. Also, just wanted to share that, you know, the staff have been doing just a phenomenal job this year and getting quite a bit done. There's been some really spectacular things. And as we go into the budget season, I wanted to just make people aware of kind of how tight the ship we've run. The National Recreation Park Association just shared their annual field report last month. It highlights information that I want to say is 455 agencies reported into us. They go along with it. So we get all this information back to us. They collect a lot of data, a lot of information on parks departments across the country. Some of the numbers when they came back were really startling for the staff and I. The median amount of operating expenditures per acre across the country, and my business from parks all over, it's a big swath, even from Chicago to the little tiny places in Arkansas. But the median, so exactly half or more, exactly half or less, operating expenditure per acre is about 6,800. Porter County, we spend about 1,100. So 6,800 is the median, 1,100 is about what we spend here. The median number of full-time positions authorized is 48. It's 6. The percentage of your revenue as an operating cost, the median number is 30. that, I got nothing. I don't have any questions.
Questions, anyone?
Mr. Chairman, just a comment. I've been fortunate to attend two of the music events out there at the Shell now, and I want to commend the staff on the presentation they put on out there. They take very good care of the grounds, and you're very fortunate to have an electrician that spends the amount of time and effort out there that you do, particularly with food truck line and things like that. So, I'd like to see more music events out there, and also maybe see if there's another way we could promote it also through either the park website or something like that to get more people yet out there. We still have a little bit of room in the park.
I have a question.
Just like winter lights, if it wasn't for Jack, then it wasn't much of that. Flames are back to back.
Thank you, Jack. Yes?
When you talk about these median numbers, and you're talking 48 staff as a median, how many acres are we in comparison to? So we have 6 in comparison to whatever acreage, that 48 in comparison to what acreage?
You know, I don't know. They didn't share a median number of acres for the department.
That's a good, that'd be something interesting to know.
They do have, one of the items that they did report is acres per 1,000 population. That median is 19.22. Porter County has 0.94, Porter County Parks, mind you, has 0.94 acres per 1,000 residents. So
when you look at this, interpolated from there.
Yeah, and usually what happens, because this is part of our 5-year master plan, this all comes up, that when you look at the county in general, according to the national standards and the state of Indiana standards, we have enough parkland in the county of Porter. But it's because we have the state park and the national park that get included in that number. Once you go south of that area, especially south of Valpo, when you look at the local park acreage that's available to residents, we are way, way below any of the standards that have been established.
There's also a thing that's happened since parks and years before Porter and Belt Recreation and Trail. You have something like the Prairie Inland Trail or the Calumet Trail, which is one used mostly as adults or sometimes adults as children, but not organized youth sports or anything like that. And it gets lumped in with ball fields, it gets lumped in with nature. And so the statistics may be getting more confused over time.
Yeah.
I had this exchange with the park director in Chesterton. He said, oh, we have more acres than we should have. But it's all because they just bought the trail.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't because they added any ball fields. They had any ball grounds for that year too, I think. But they were complacent because they met the average that they added this trail, but it wasn't serving the kids.
Yes, sir.
How many acres do we actually take care of? Get our equipment there back and forth. It takes time and money.
Yep.
And the amount of the manpower they have is the staff. And I also work there part time. We're busy constantly. And the equipment takes a beating.
Yep.
I did also have additional appropriate relations for houses.
You want to do that now?
Yeah, I might as well just do it at that point. Craven asked about the field additional appropriation, $604.75 for the IDR2T Park Fund. I also, the budget personnel committee just $3,005 that is left in salary line item, that's a mistake on our part that we should be extended, to actually the running of the program, which still continues. But I've identified an additional allocation of that so that we can close that out. The process for that, if approved, go to the council, they approve the additional allocation, we can spend those dollars, and then I would ask Mr. Hollenbeck to draft and let us close that fund, which we get to some fund creation as well. We have fund 4918, $604.75, and fund number 9200, $3,005 out of salaries.
Any questions? Motion?
Motion to approve.
Walter, we'll share that with you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need a copy of it because I do the draft.
Why don't you take that? And Walter will send that same document out by email.
David said something about putting the fund number in.
Apparently, the commissioners want to have a blank in their ordinance form for new funds that includes a place where they can just enter in the number in consultation with the auditor. Vicki says she's been actually saying the number out loud at a couple of meetings while they're passing the ordinance so that the number gets, she tries to get it into the commission minutes so that a future person going through the minutes can see that number and then know where to look it up in the auditor.
Okay.
Okay. So we have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Mr. Armstrong.
Yes.
Skinner?
Yes.
Mr. Schnabel?
Yes.
Mr. Archer?
Yes. Education Center and Farm Program up back up.
Yes. One thing. So during our budget and personnel meeting, Mr. Skinner asked a great question. We're going to need three ordinances, Mr. Hollenbeck, for the closing of the Kane property this fall. Three different funding sources that we're putting together. So we need you, if the board is okay, to draft three ordinances.
I tried for years, and the previous auditors, and excuse isn't probably the right word, but explanation was that his auditors wanted all this money segregated, and so, and that's why we got so many funds. I'm sorry, this involves the Kane property.
The Kane acquisition, yeah, correct.
Well, that's right, because we have three different sources of funding.
Yes, sir.
And that is, it's gonna close September, would be right now.
September, October.
And we need to be dropping some.
You got it, my friend.
Okay, it sounds like at the next board, say at the next board meeting, I will have.
Please, thank you.
Is it?
Yeah, I promise.
All right, that's fine. Education center and farm program update.
There's even one fund where we're still not quite sure whether.
I thought we were done.
There's one fund where we're not quite sure whether it's ours or E911, because they predated tile, and the commissioner met a record and everything, our record, don't quite jive. So, and currently it's spelled as E911.
I think for the record, I need to say that Walter and I have done everything we were told to do in the order we were told to do it. Even to the point where I've reached out and done things for Betty Knight, the county attorney, that if I didn't have 33 years as a county council lawyer, I wouldn't be able to. I think we've gone beyond what we had to do. What else can we do but hand the ordinance, creating the fund with the commissioners, they approve it. We hand it to the auditor, and I can't do the auditor's work. Or some I could, but I choose not.
You're going in the right direction.
Good.
I would choose that.
Yeah, we had a good meeting with them. Anything else?
No.
Education center and farm program update? Anything to report?
Well, we did have a meeting with the contractor, Mr. Baverick, and a bunch of his consultants, and reviewed a bunch of electrical stuff, really exciting, funny conversation, really thrilling stuff. It's progressing nicely. We need to schedule a meeting with the interior finishing folks. Tom has let me know, because we're just trying to herd the cat, so to speak, and getting everybody together. It's proving to be a little bit more difficult than we had hoped. So our schedule is probably a slide, a week or two, or three. Not a big thing. We still
have that works.
Yeah, yeah. We still anticipate being able to get bids out this fall and get those responses back. So, if possible, it could be included in the county budget conversation.
McKeeke Park report.
I had an update this week from the Dune Group. They completed the stormwater system plan. Most of the parking lot has been completed. They're working on finding the essentially what it's called turning way out the water. As the way where the water can tank, can be slowed down, can be cleaned. We are leading at a slower rate for stragglers. And they're working with adjacent property owners to find out where they're going forward. So we're taking this data that we have.
Programs and education update? Bring across. I know Ray has a.
I have a couple pictures. I was out there today. I've been out there almost every day for the last couple weeks. Working on the contract and working with ASCII. So I snapped a couple photos today to give you a little bit of a progress report of where we're at, where we're going. We remember the drawing, the northwest corner, a nice big loop that's been completed. The grading's been done, the fabric's been laid down, and the stone has been installed. There's approximately 3 inches of what is called 53s, and then another inch of fines across the top. We're going to make compacts with the night. 6 foot wide, they did a real nice job cleaning up the edges. I think I've become a pain because I'm out there constantly. Keep them in line and make sure it's done nice and done correctly.
they have some older ones that were hand built. Here's another image of it. It's really nice. We're gonna, like I've mentioned before, all nice accessible trails. For you guys, mobility issues should not have a problem. Traversing through our trail system. I'm really excited about it. Walter's been out there. We've taken a hike.
You're gonna say, are we allowed to go?
Yeah, I would love, if anybody wants to go out there next week, we can have to let me know. We'll have to take a tour. Walter, all.
Not sound very well.
We'll leave that going.
I sure do.
It doesn't go on the roof.
Trails are great, bugs are awful.
Bugs are awful.
That's why the ribbon cutting to October.
I'm gonna go out there in the weekend and show kids off or out.
Short run.
This is the method they're doing. They're going through with their little dozer on the front of it. They go through the clearness. And then they have this probe as they're pointing back as well. And it's cleaning up the edges real nice.
That looks pretty sandy.
It's all sand up there. It's pretty much all sand. Been all in. Yep, so they're working hard. They have it looks like a mini dump truck that they're driving back there. It's up the stone. And then they plug it out. They're completing it as they go. They've been piled with stone, so they're going to have to drive back over it. So it's really nice, really exciting. Here's another picture of it. You can see how it starts to wind through there. This is because we, early in the year, creep bugs, there's still snow on the ground. We walk through and identify trees, and we're out big trees, and we make sure we get all the nice specimen trees. And then it turned out being a real nice how it's really windy like this.
Thank you. out. Sorry, hit the streets, they did a fantastic job, give it on the time, it is absolutely fantastic.
Is it in the mail and showing up?
Yeah, well, we don't, because we already have a phone call, and of course, you know, this is extension mailbox, and phone starts ringing, it's a great thing. What's not a great thing is when the first phone call comes in the office, and you tell them, saying, hey, by the way, I got your program, guy, it looks great. The trip to the factory, you say, that Austin Park is in Oregon Township, and not Pleasant Township. So there may be a, but so, there may be a running show in our office about who we're blaming.
At least they're looking at that.
You're getting blamed for it.
Our receiving park planner.
Oregon Pleasant, 220-21.
Yeah, it's more after than the other. But, other than that, Dana has asked, the staff if there's any input regarding, marketing, and sales and rentals specifically, in our policy. We start putting that together now. It just worked out nice. And on Sunday, Drew asked me, well, hey, are we going to get back together? So we're planning on probably by October-ish, to sit down and review, the rental policy again, because there's been some new stuff that's come up, and there's some things that, of course, have been really importantly anticipated, so that by November we can have an updated policy for the park board, so that we can begin marketing and putting that in the system. Because we've already got, what, September 2016, we've already got the HL page. Yeah, it's kind of crazy. So that's a good thing, but we've got to stay ahead of the curve. The only other thing I'd mention is that, of course, in the front of your minds, not only is October 20th, the ribbon cutting out at Brinka, but Saturday, November 21st, is winter night. Rain is in full effect for winter night already. Means that just a ton of really cool new stuff is going to happen. And so it's a gingerbread house competition this year.
They start at 3?
3:00.
Look at how exciting that is. He doesn't have any hair.
Nothing wrong with that.
No,
it's pretty neat. They sent them the CAD on for the closed playground. They put it into this machine here, and they go out to that to the town and tell them where it goes, and they're able to identify the center line and the sidewalk, the curve, the edge is really cool. And, and it acts as both of them.
Comments or questions?
We got a name for that, boy.
Yeah.
camp to get over, so we can get started back in getting our work done. And that's sort of tied up in the shop for a little while.
I don't know, there's been a lot of guys out there getting a lot of work done, so it's a little food. There's been a lot going on up there.
Yeah, well, we got all the crops in for the wheat and the oats and for the show, and we want to get the doors and stuff done, so. Then Sunday, there's three of us pulling wagons. We've got the handicap wagon back out there, so.
I see your signs all over the place.
Hey, we try to get everybody in there to the show.
What's the date you have, right? You should be on.
Twenty-fifth, twenty-sixth, twenty-seventh?
Yeah, so it's the fourth weekend?
Yeah, I think so.
It's the last weekend of September. It's the 25th, 26th, 27th, you're right.
Okay, anything else, any questions? Foundation report, Mr. Neville.
I'm pleased to report that communication is moving forward. Walter and I have been sitting down quite a bit and talking. We are working at recruiting new members for the board, and met with Porter County Community Foundation. We're ready to apply for a grant to help us articulate the policies of our board. I'm just very encouraged by the activity that's taking place right now. Only time will tell. I'm procedure driven, so I'm very much I'm going to be looking for, you know, the opportunity to develop a system that, you know, operates like an engine. That's basically it as far as, you know, where we're at with the board. It's going to take time. This is not five minute undertaking. One thing that, you know, for example, Walter has accepted the executive director position in regards to the Coca-Cola application that we're putting in on behalf of the foundation. So we're creating some links. Things are starting to move forward in regards to tying us closer together. Walter also did request that we throw our support out there in regards to a budget that I've been made aware of that's coming up in regards to the Porter County hospital that was sold. And this is new to me, guys. I've never been in, you know, in this position trying to talk to the public officials and whatnot. So my question to the board is I'm very interested in talking to them. You know, we need more funding. You know, when we have an average fund per capita of 250 for argument's sake, and Valparaiso has 950 per capita, you know, we're underdogs before we can begin, right? So, you know, I'm curious if we can create a collaboration. How is it that we can approach the councilmen to, you know, encourage them to throw their support, their budget support this way? I don't want to just, you know, approach them, you know, by myself without having a good understanding of where we're going. And one of the examples that came across even in this meeting, and for example, we're losing our accountant on our board, and one of trying to get an exit interview with him, and so I asked for clarification of what his position was, and one of his positions was that we don't have any parks in his neck of the woods, so he really has no real interest in being part of our organization. You know, but now I can see, I don't know what the history is, but I laid out a map of, you know, where the properties are in regards to where the board's working on, and I can see that we're making movements, you know, across the county. And, you know, so those are kind of messages, you know, what is the strategic position long-term, and if they think it's something that's going to happen in the next couple of years, then I guess that's something you guys got to address, but that's not going to happen, right? But are we looking at going across the county in all directions and providing an environment that benefits the entire county? You know, I would like to be able to work with you guys and figure out how it is that we're going to talk to these folks and try to get their minds.
Maybe Walter, we could sit down and strategize. I'd be happy to sit on some. If you guys can get your calendars, we'll let him be the man there. And
very good.
For sure.
The sooner the better, because it's coming up late. Well, I don't know if they do it every year, right?
They're a foundation representative on the land acquisition.
us not, Herb Reed on that? Oh, Herb is not a...
He's a foundation member.
He's a foundation, okay. All right, board member, sorry.
Anyway, it's a thought.
Yeah. Yeah, we'd be happy to...
Start moving forward.
Make a position available or put someone on that so they can at least have the, be able to have the understanding of what... I mean, we're always looking for willing sellers.
Okay.
Walter's done a very good job in the short time that he's been here seeking out, things. I think, Kiki Park is probably one of our greatest efforts to move things south of Division Road. You know, except for Dunn's Bridge, that's the second part, you know, south of Division, so we have made strides.
And we're in negotiations for the other river part.
Yeah.
There you go, I mean, this is all part of that strategic, getting a good understanding before we try to talk to these folks that are across.
Well, we had to do the 5-year plan, there's a chance for people to weigh in on this kind of stuff. But the committee, and sometimes it's made it to the board, we've looked at parcels. And some of this is in closed session, so I can't name the parcels, but in a lot of different townships, and look at it seriously, sometimes it falls through because the appraisal comes back too high, or sometimes it's competing with another one and the grant money's available for one and that, or this or that. But we've looked at parcels. There's a couple of townships, I may have never seen a flood in parcels. Most every township we've looked at parcels.
Another factor, and I'm not saying I disagree with this, is the board's feeling that we ought not engage in condemnation in order to acquire land. In other words, we don't want to take land from people.
We did that once, and it was not a pleasure.
And so we are receptive to people who offer us land, if they want to be paid for it, but we're not in a position, unless this board would change its policy, to be going out and saying, we want a park in this township, that looks like a good piece of land, the owner doesn't want to sell it, and we...
No, that wouldn't create good vibes.
Right, and you're right, but that also limits our options. I mean, we have to sit back and see what comes to us as opposed to being out.
And that's the message following through the strategic plan. The fact is that you've already been out there doing the work, there's evidence in relationship. I mean, how do we really bridge that conversation with these folks and say that we really do care about them and their people in their in their parts of the county? You're describing it right now by your conversation.
Oh, I thought that was something out there.
I think that's what I was saying.
That's our problem.
We might be able to tell you if we're careful, and so we don't violate the executive, you know, the closed session, the negotiation on the problem. We might be able to tell you which areas we've already looked at and why it fell through in a general way. So you know that we were looking. I don't think we rolled anything out. We're not saying we're not going somewhere if we're going to like those folks.
I said that we'll get with Walter and we'll try to organize meetings and sit down and discuss this. See how we would like to articulate that approach before I start going banging on the doors. Thank you.
Anything else? Public comments. Anyone in the audience like to Herb, Charlotte?
Award-winning Herb and Charlotte.
That's right.
Award-winning, nationally recognized Herb and Charlotte.
Does it come with like a stipend? I'd like to thank everybody for coming tonight.
Mr. Chairman, I do owe you I owe you and the board an apology for my absence Tuesday night. It wasn't intended, but I was delayed in another meeting, and by the time I got here, you folks had done your business and left
pretty quick.
I got here about quarter after.
We weren't here 5 minutes.
And I got here quarter after, and you guys were described as having been long gone.
Well, we got here like between quarter till and 10 till, and he
wouldn't let us start until five, so.
David, I'm proud of you.